Live from U.S. Cellular Field in Chicago, Illinois, Nesson presents Boston Red Sox Baseball. Tonight, the Red Sox take on the Chicago White Sox. Hi, everybody. I'm Don Orsillo, as always, joined by Jerry Remy. The first game of the series with the White Sox. Manny Ramirez is healthy, but not in the lineup tonight.
Well, Don, it's a shame that we're in the middle of a pennant race, but we have to open talking about the Manny Ramirez saga that continues to go on. Manny reported to the ballpark today, said that he could DH. Grady Little said, no, you're not playing. And this is basically punishment for what's going on for the last couple of days. The fact that Manny did not show up at the ballpark on Sunday, the fact that yesterday he was asked numerous times to pinch in that ballgame and said he couldn't do so. Grady Little feels that if today he puts him in the starting lineup, he loses the rest of the ball club. They're all upset at the fact that Manny, the episodes of the last couple of days. So the fact is, he is not in the starting lineup today. We don't know when he's going to get back into the starting lineup. It's not a suspension, but it's almost the same thing.
Well, the Red Sox open up this two-game series with the White Sox tonight. It's John Burkett against Bartolo Colon, and it's next on Nesson.
Cash or credit?
Oh, hey, Yahoo. Oh, making me dizzy. Oh, Bank One.
British Airways?
Bank One.
Top of the morning to you. I'm not really British. I sound like it, don't I?
Borders. Let me guess. Bank One?
Bank One.
Bank One.
Hey, Helen, another Bank One.
Hundreds of leading names, one you.
This is so you.
Find the car that fits you best.
Cute dog. You two have the same eyes.
Individual answers. Bank One.
Sweet system.
Yeah, it's a new CD and MP3 player.
And I dig how it handles. You think they designed this in Europe or something?
I just drove quite a few of those, and the Focus is in a class all its own.
Did you drive the ZX3, the ZX5, or the SVT?
All the above, and the SVT kicked.
Did you get that deal on TV, the 0 for 60 or 3,000 cash back?
Sure did.
And it came with a 5-year, 100,000-mile extended service plan?
Yeah.
Look again at the best-selling brand of cars and trucks in New England, only at your New England Ford dealer. They did.
Your Dodge dealers are counting down the final days of the summer sales drive. It's your chance to get no extra charge lube, oil, and filter changes for up to 7 years. Plus, make zero down payment. Zero payments until 2004, and get 0% APR financing or cash allowances of up to $4,500. All with our 7-year, 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. But get rolling, because the final days countdown ends September 2nd. See your Dodge dealer for the best values in America.
The world is constantly changing. My world.
My world.
My world.
Now, get 50% off home delivery of the Sunday Globe for 12 weeks. Call 1-800-467-4455 today and keep up with the changes in your world.
The stories I want with one call, one deal.
News, the arts,
sports.
There's one place I keep ahead of the curve.
I get home delivery of the Globe.
Call 1-800-467-4455 for home delivery of the Sunday Globe. Get award-winning news and one of the best sports sections in the country for just $1.50 a week. That's 50% off.
I get the whole scene.
The inside scoop.
I wake up to the Boston Globe.
One paper. One call.
One deal. Get the award-winning Sunday Globe delivered to you at 50% off for 12 weeks. Call now and get 4 extra weeks at 50% off when you use your credit card. Call today.
Introducing Magner's Irish Cider, Ireland's original hard cider, for a unique kind of refreshment. Because let's face it, there's no thirst like an Irish thirst. Magner's Irish Cider, real cider, imported from Ireland.
Nesson is New England's hardball headquarters with complete Boston Red Sox coverage, Paw Sox action from McCoy, and the Sox newest affiliate, the Portland Sea Dogs. Nesson's playing ball all season long.
Boston Red Sox baseball and Nesson is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, by your Boston area Lexus dealers, by Citizens Bank, and by Dunkin' Donuts. Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome back to U.S. Cellular Field in Chicago, Illinois. In the first of a brief two-game series between the Red Sox and the Chicago White Sox, let's take a look at the visiting Boston Red Sox starting lineup brought to you by Dodge. Johnny Damon leads it off in center field. Todd Walker at second base, batting second. Omar Garcia Parr at shortstop. David Ortiz in the cleanup spot as the DH, with Kevin Millar at first base. Todd Nixon in right. Bill Miller getting the start at third. Jason Varitek doing the catching, batting eighth. And Gabe Kapler in left field, bats ninth.
And the defense for the Chicago White Sox is brought to you by your Boston area Lexus dealers. They're third in the league with 78 errors on the season. It'll be Joe Greedy at third base, Jose Valentin the shortstop, Robbie Alomar at second base. You see, he's won 10 gold gloves in his career. And Paul Konerko, the first baseman, left to right, Carlos Lee, Carl Everett, and Maglio Adonias. Miguel Olivo doing the catching, and on the mound, Bartolo Colon. 12-11 on the season, his 29th start, a record of 4.18. He's among the league leaders in strikeouts at 153. He is currently on a two-game winning streak. He won his last two against Texas and last time against the New York Yankees. 0-1 against the Red Sox. And Don, if you recall that game against Boston, it seems like he threw an awful lot of breaking balls in that game. And obviously, this guy is a power pitcher. Let's see how he approaches the Sox lineup tonight.
They didn't have the power with him last time. The crew chief, Joe Brinkman, has the plate. Mike DeMuro at first base. Darryl Cousins at second. And Andy Fletcher, the umpire, at third. Johnny Damon getting ready to step in here to begin the ball game tonight. Very cool temperatures here tonight in Chicago, as kind of a breeze blowing from left to right across the outfield to begin the evening. And the temperature is a little bit on the cool side here tonight. No humidity whatsoever in Chicago. As Johnny Damon stands in at 276, 11 homers and 54 runs batted in. Gets it over for strike one to Johnny Damon to begin the ball game. Sliced foul down the left field line back into the seats. And Damon quickly down 0-2.
Red Sox have always had pretty good success against Colon. They are 4-7. I should say Colon is 4-7 in his career against Red Sox teams.
Just missing to Damon. I mentioned that Colon has a two-game winning streak coming in. He has 12 wins but 11 losses on the season. 9 years of age, and this is that time to Damon to even the count now at 2-2. Johnny Damon reaching base 4 times yesterday, scoring 2 runs. 7-25 against Colon as he grounds one fouled over by the on-deck circle.
Well, you missed the game yesterday, Don, and you missed a beauty. I'll tell you what, a marathon affair in Philadelphia, and the Red Sox, of course, battling back to win that game, and a pretty good feeling on that plane as they headed to Chicago. That was a tough ball game and a good ball game to win.
Ball 3 now to Damon. Kind of exemplifies really what the Red Sox have been all about in this 2003 season. Never give up, and able to really come back from any deficit at any time, and having that confidence all season long, as they did yesterday as well. 3-2 is popped up right side of the Chicago infield, while Konerko in the lip of the grass handles out number one.
Well, let's check tonight's game notes, brought to you by a New England Toyota dealer. The season series 2-2. All 4 games have been played right here at U.S. Cellular Field. Each team with 14 runs scored. Burkett, 62% of his strikeouts are looking. That's the highest percentage by American League starters. And the White Sox, 28-15 since the All-Star break. That's the best record in the major leagues. This is a different White Sox club than the last time we saw them down there. Offense much improved.
Where available, tonight's broadcast can be heard in Spanish by using the SAP function on your TV set.
Buenas noches, amigos.
Here's Todd Walker. For the first time tonight, Todd checks in, hitting at 274, 10 homers. And 69 runs batted in. Over the last 13 games, Todd Walker hitting at 326. And quickly in the hole here, 0-2 against Colon.
Here's the scouting report on Colon. Anywhere from 92 to 98 with the fastball. He gets stronger as the game goes on. Slider, very good pitch, and also a changeup. Although that slider was the one that he threw a lot to the Red Sox the last outing, and the Red Sox did some pretty good damage against Colon. I still think his best pitch is his fastball.
Stands at 5'11", listed at 240. As Walker strikes out on 3 pitches. First strikeout of the night for Colon, and there's 2 down.
Now the pitch
pitching coach of the Chicago White Sox, Don Cooper, talks about his pitcher, Bartolo Colon.
Fastball, curveballs, it's a slider. He can create a slider spin and a cutter, as well as changeup. And an outstanding fastball. When he's locating it, it's very tough, difficult for the hitters. With three other good pitches, like I said, curveball, he can get a slide, he can form a slider, and a little cut fastball as well as that changeup. So he certainly has all the physical.
He deals with Nomar Garcia Parra here with two down, nobody on.
Now you heard him mention the fact when he locates the fastball, that's exactly what he did to Todd Walker. That fastball tail back to the inside corner for the strikeout.
Nomar jumps back out of the way of that pitch. Garcia Parra in a three-way tie for second in the American League in batting average at 322 to begin the night. Garrett Anderson and Derek Jeter as he lines this one foul. The league leader to begin the night is Bill Miller at 323. Then Garrett Anderson, Derek Jeter, and Nomar Garcia Parra.
Nomar also leads the league in hits, 183 hits, one more than Ichiro.
The 1-2. Omar strikes up. Back-to-back games for Cologne. In order go the Red Sox. They get nothing. White Sox coming up from Chicago.
The Hyundai Elantra. A comparison. More standard features than a Toyota Corolla LE. All for over $1,900 less when comparably equipped. And only the Elantra is protected by America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. Looks like we have a winner. Test drive the Hyundai Elantra. Nicely equipped for just $12,199. At your Hyundai dealer. Hurry into the Hyundai winning season clearance and get up to $2,000 cash back or 0% APR for up to 60 months.
Mr. Thompson, after hearing the evidence and listening to your testimony, this committee finds you guilty of obstruction of justice, embezzlement of company funds, and questionable accounting practices. Well, there appears to be some good news.
Yes, sir?
Well, I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico. Thanks very much.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Welcome to the House of Beer. We have 170 kinds of beer from all over the world. The beers are color-coded and separated by country, style, and color. Call me when you're ready.
I'm ready. All the Sam Adams.
Yeah.
You can go around the world and not find a better beer than Samuel Adams. Always a good decision.
Hard work. Experience. Lead to success. Hamill, Waxler, Allen, and Collins. Personal injury law.
Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back in Chicago as the Red Sox don't score in the top of the first. White Sox coming to bat in the bottom of the first inning. Different looking White Sox order, as we have mentioned, since the last time the Red Sox saw the White Sox. And it starts right here. Roberto Alomar leading it off here in the bottom of the first inning.
John Burkett, start number 26 on the season, 9-7, has not had a win since August 7th against Anaheim. Since that time, a couple of losses to Oakland and Seattle, and back-to-back no decisions against Seattle and Toronto, but the Red Sox did win both of those games. He beat Cologne here earlier in the season, 1-0 this year against the White Sox.
And you may remember it was a very tough start for him as he gave up four consecutive doubles out of the gate and then went on to retire 18 in a row after that. And it was a tough beginning, but a very nice ending for John Burkett that night. And he faces the White Sox here again tonight as he goes after his 10th win of the year. This is lined towards right center field. It'll get down for a base hit. Nixon over to cut it off quickly. Alomar trying for two, and he'll get there with a double to begin things here in the bottom of the first inning. take a look at the rest of the Chicago White Sox lineup brought to you by Dodge. We've seen Alomar, Carlos Lee at second in left field, Frank Thomas the DH, Maglio Ordonez in right field, Carl Everett in center field, Walker Urko at first base, Jose Valentin at shortstop, Joe Creedy at third, and Miguel Olivo, the catcher, bats ninth for the White Sox. So the 26th double of the year for Roberto Alomar. As Carlos Lee stands in and takes ball one from John Burkett. He had 284, 27 home runs and 95 runs batted in.
Now the biggest difference, Don, in this White Sox team now than the last time we saw them, the offense. And they had really struggled early in the year. But they have too many good hitters on this team to struggle all year long. And since the All-Star break, in particular, they have really been hitting well.
Overall, and it's because the problems you mentioned early in the season, they are 11th in the league in hitting at .262, but that has dramatically changed. And this guy has put together an amazing season for the White Sox. Last time we were here, Jerry, Paul Konerko was hitting under .200. And that was right around the halfway point of the season. He has dramatically picked it up lately.
Yeah, Thomas has been hitting a lot of home runs. He's got 38 home runs on the season, second to A-Rod in the American League. You mentioned Konerko. Konerko really has got hot, and you kind of expected him to. I mean, he's too good a hitter to continue all season long the way he did in that first half.
Alomar at second base, nobody out, and the 2-2. Air to shallow center. Johnny Damon moves in and under, and he makes the catch for the first out.
We'll take a look at the Red Sox defense, brought to you by a Boston area Lexus dealers. Bill Miller at third base, Nomar the shortstop, Todd Walker at second, and Kevin Millar at first. Left to right, Gabe Kapler, Johnny Damon, and Trot Nixon. Jason Veritek doing the catching for John Burkett.
So one down, Roberto Alomar at second base. That brings up the big hurt, Frank Thomas. The DH tonight hitting at .267. The home runs, 38 of them this season, 90 runs batted in. Frank Thomas has had 18 home runs in the second half. Major League leader in that department, second half home runs with his 18. And he's had 10 home runs over the last 13 games. He is second only to A-Rod. For the Texas Rangers, who has 40 on the season. Look out when he gets hit. He grabbed him on the shoulder, tough to tell as he makes his way down to first base to hit batsman.
Veritek sets up inside, the fastball too far inside as he gets Frank Thomas right off the left arm. I don't know if that's the bicep, tricep, or whatever it is, but I don't think it hurt Frank very much.
They got a little bit.
He's got big biceps and big triceps.
A little bit of both, but he's got some big ones. You're right about that. 2-1, one away. Maglio Ordonez stands in. The White Sox cleanup hitter. Checks in hitting at .321 on the season, 25 home runs and 82 runs batted in. Well, hit safely in eight straight games as Ordonez. 12 for 29 during that time at .414 over the last eight games.
There you see the numbers against John Burkett, 6 for 12. There's a couple of guys in this lineup, Frank Thomas, Ordonez, Alomar, have all had good success against Burkett.
John making his 26th start of the year, 27th appearance overall. And that's in there for a strike.
Scouting report on John Burkett. Of course, the fastball will be anywhere from 83 to maybe 86. That 12-6 curveball, which he changes speeds on. More of a cut fastball than a slider for Burkett. And of course, he has to be absolutely perfect with his location.
Spiraled off the backside, bluffing as Alomar returns to the bag.
Alomar with six steals since coming over to the White Sox. Been caught a couple of times.
Has the plate. The crew chief is a four-man crew here tonight in Chicago. And this is ball four. There's the first walk of the night given up by John Burkett, and the White Sox have the bases loaded with one down in the inning. Of the double to Alomar. He had Carlos Lee to fly out to center, then he hits Frank Thomas and walks Maglior Donias. Now he's got to deal with one of the newer members of the Chicago White Sox, Carl Everett, at 284, 25 home runs and 77 runs batted in between his work with the Texas Rangers and the second half here in Chicago. And on the hands, he fouls it off the left side.
Yeah, overall, very, very good numbers on the season for Carl Everett. You see his career with the bases loaded, eight grand slams. A bit of a struggle recently, six for his last 27.
Over the last two games, 0 for 7. Is popped up foul back and out of play. Jason Varitek trying to locate it. He does, and there's no chance to grab that.
A little bit tough right now, isn't it? Picking up the pop-up and fly balls. You're at twilight here in Chicago. And that sky right now, very, very difficult for infielders, outfielders, catchers, anything hitting the air. It'll stay like this for probably about 5 to 10 minutes, which could really be a problem.
Well, Varitek discarded the mask very quickly, then looked up, couldn't find it. Would not have had a chance anyway to get that ball as it landed about four rows deep. Well, the 0-2. Everett slashes at it, foul back to the backstop.
Now, Red Sox still have five games remaining with the White Sox. The two here in Chicago, then a three-game series at Fenway Park, and these are going to be very difficult games. This team now two games in front in the Central Division.
And two in a row coming into tonight's action. Real close, Everett taking it for a ball. John Bergen is going to need Joe Brinkman to give him those corners tonight if he is going to be successful. And that really has been the case all season long for John Burkett, who attempts to paint those corners. A 1-2. Everett reaches out, pops it up into shallow right center, falling fast. Out goes Walker, and it'll fall. Scoring from third base is Alomar. The throw to third is in time to get Thomas. So they do get the out there, but a run is in for the White Sox, and they lead it 1-0. Almost looked like Walker was looking for Damon to catch that ball.
He was looking for help. There's no question about that. And I don't know if that's because maybe he didn't see the ball well, but you can clearly see when he's heading back for this pop-up that he looks twice toward Johnny Damon for help. There's the second look. The ball drops in. Fortunately, they do get the one out at third base. One look, two looks. Can't pick up the baseball. Ball drops in. A run comes home, but they do get the force out at third base. How in the heck do you score that, Don?
It's a good question. That would go 4-5, correct?
I would think so. On the fielder's choice?
On the fielder's choice. Yes, Paul Konerko stands in. Yeah. Paul Konerko at 244, 15 homers and 57 runs batted in. And the fielder's choice, Annie, gets credit for the RBI. Which scored Roberto Alomar. The White Sox with a 1-0 lead here. They had the bases loaded with one down so far. They've been able to get a run in. They have Ordonez at second and Everett over at first base.
Last time we were in town, Konerko was hitting below 200. Now he's at 244 with the 15 home runs.
Breakdown, Jerry. First half 197, five home runs, 319 in the second half, and into double figures in home runs. Goes the opposite way to right. Nixon moving in, still coming, and he'll make the running catch. So Burkett gets out of it, giving up just the one run. We've played one from Chicago, and the White Sox have the 1-0 lead.
Okay, folks, let's get this party started. Call Seattle. Get McGregor on the phone.
Calling him now.
Morning.
Good morning.
This is Scott McGregor. I'll be out of the office all day. Please leave a message.
That's not like McGregor.
McGregor's not there?
Great.
Excuse me, there's a Mr. McGregor here to see you.
Southwest Airlines last-minute fares. If you're paying more than $149 nonstop to Orlando or Tampa Bay, you're paying too much.
You are now free to move about the country.
For extra convenience, extra value, and extra service, stop at Extra Mart. When you're on the go, you need a little extra. Fuel up on Extra Mart's Deli Joe sandwiches, Brew Boy coffee, and more. For your car, Extra Mart offers the brands you know at competitive prices.
Pick up irresistibly delicious, extra nutritious Nesquik. Now on sale for only 99 cents at Extra Mart. Nesquik, milk made fun.
With over 150 locations throughout New England, be smart. Shop Extra Mart.
Try a delicious breakfast sandwich on a freshly baked bagel from Dunkin' Donuts. It's just the thing you've been waiting for. Stop by today for any one of our delicious breakfast sandwiches, including the new sourdough bagel sandwich for just $1.99. Just the thing.
Nothing has changed. Everything has changed. The all-new 265 horsepower Nissan Maxima.
Back in Chicago, the White Sox on top 1-0 as we head into the top of the second inning. Red Sox win in order in the first. And it's David Ortiz, Kevin Millar, and Trout Nixon in the inning. Ortiz in the cleanup spot again tonight. 291, 23 homers and 80 runs batted in. In the air to left field, Carlos Lee jogging back is under it, and he makes the catch for the first out here in the second inning.
Red Sox will team up with the American Red Cross and Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center to host a blood drive September 11th at Fenway Park. The drive will run from 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. in the 406 Club. Donors will receive a Red Sox gift bag and will be entertained by Red Sox personalities while they wait. Your support can help save lives, so please join us September 11th in supporting this important effort.
Here's Kevin Millar, who gets the start at first base tonight for the Red Sox.
Well, in case you joined us late, Manny Ramirez not in the lineup tonight, although he was able to DH, is what he told Grady Little, and Grady Little said basically, no thank you. And that clearly a punishment for the goings-on of the last couple of days, the fact that Manny did not report on Sunday to the ballpark, the fact that yesterday was unable to pinch hit in that ball game, and I think Grady had a long night last night thinking about how he was going to be handling this situation because the club, the teammates, were not very pleased at all.
You know, I think as Malai lifts it in the air, right side, Second baseman Alomar calling, and the short-handed second baseman makes the catch, two down. You know, I think you brought up a good point in the pregame show. Oftentimes, what is a big deal to everybody else often doesn't enter the clubhouse and is that big a deal.
Yeah.
This to the players was a very big deal.
Yeah, I agree, Don. You know, I've seen an awful lot that goes on in major league teams that people don't see, don't hear about, and as long as it doesn't have an effect on the fellow teammates, then, you know, you kind of let a lot of things ride. This is not. There are a lot of guys that are very upset what has gone on in the last couple of days, and Little's only choice was to do what he did. When he's ready, he's not playing. Now, the question is, how long is that going to go on? Obviously, if there was a game-winning situation that comes up tonight, would he ask Manny to pinch it? Yes, I think he would. Does that mean he will start him tomorrow? I'm not so sure about that.
He has definitely sent a message, though, to the rest of the team. With Manny not starting here tonight, Ramirez did say he could DH, but as you mentioned, Grady Little opted not to use him here tonight.
I had about 10 minutes alone with him this afternoon early, and, you know, he was explaining about that ball game yesterday, how these guys battled and battled and battled, and Johnny Damon playing hurt. And some of the comments the players made after the game, didn't name anybody in particular, but everybody knew what they were talking about. He said, how in the world can I put this guy in the lineup today and have no respect from anybody in that clubhouse? Now, is it a better lineup with Manny in? Of course it's a better lineup with Manny in there. But sometimes you have to send the message, and that's the message that he's decided to send to this rest of the 24 guys in this ball game tonight.
1-2 to Nixon. He'll miss, and it's 2-2. Are you surprised with the way he did it in saying that he does not have his... wants to have his best team out there,
well,
to win? I mean, he hit 455, as you mentioned, against Cologne.
Read between the lines. He obviously, you know, you don't have your best team out there when Manny's not in there. I mean, that's just common sense. But by saying his best team, what he meant to say is the guys that want to play.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what he was saying to the media today in the best way that he possibly could.
You didn't really have to feel for Grady in this situation also. Of course, right now, he just got enough to worry about with victories and trying to win here down the stretch run, playing some very good teams here on the road and what is an extremely important road trip.
Well, I find it pretty sad that we are in the month of September. We have a team that has been fun to watch all season long, that has a chance to go to postseason play, and we have to be dealing with this kind of a thing. It just doesn't make much sense to me. That's the way it is in the nation at times. That's the way it is right now.
Full count here to Nixon, two down in the top half of the second inning. The White Sox on top, 1-0. Nixon lifts it in the air, deep and far to center field. Everett headed back to the track to the wall. It's gone. The hero of yesterday's game with the grand slam, and Trot Nixon here with a solo home run to tie the game at one.
Nixon has certainly rose to the occasion the last couple of games. Bartolo Colon, that fastball tailing away from Nixon, still able to pull the ball towards center field and pick up the home run to tie this ball game up. For Nixon, his home run is his 26th of the season, and for Colon, that's the 23rd home run that he has allowed.
Pretty high total.
Yeah, that is. For a guy that throws as well as Colon, that's a very high total.
Nixon with home runs and consecutive at-bats. Of course, the grand slam yesterday. And the solo home run here today, the first hit of the night for the Red Sox, as Bill Miller cranks it foul on the ground outside of first.
Now, Don, there was a release sent out by Theo Epstein that he mentioned the fact that, I think you have it right there anyway, that kind of backs the manager on this, which you need. When you make a move like this, you need the backing of the front office, and apparently he certainly got that.
As a front office, we fully support Grady's decision not to put Manny in the starting lineup tonight. He's going with a lineup that gives us the best chance to win as a team. And tonight, that does not include Manny, despite his availability to DH.
Now, the other thing that was discussed was a suspension. And that's a tough sell, obviously, because you start dealing with the Players Association and a number of different things. And quite honestly, it's one that Manny probably would win.
Right.
I mean, Manny was sick.
If he's sick, that's what they would say.
Yeah.
You can't win.
Exactly. So, you know, that's an area that I'm sure was discussed, but obviously they did not take that route. And I think that's a smart thing to do because you wouldn't win that battle.
Well, there were reports today throughout the day from a number of different media outlets that he had been suspended, and that is not the case. And the Red Sox want to clear that up as well. They're also saying today, contrary to some reports, Manny has not been suspended. He's not in the lineup tonight. And we all support Grady's decision. 2-2, foul back and out of play. Now the question is, how long does he sit, Jerry? I mean, is this a situation you wait till New York, or?
It's quite possible. I really don't know, Don. You know, I kind of hope he gets in the lineup tonight in a key situation and gets a hit. I really do. How long he's not in the starting lineup, it's kind of like a college player or something who messes up in class and the coach doesn't play him for the first half and puts him in the second half, mm-hmm. You know? I don't know. My guess is maybe not in this series, but I really don't know.
Miller sends it towards right center field. Everett on the run, moving over. He dives and makes a great catch. Carl Everett had a long way to go, and he makes the catch in right center field to rob Miller of a hit. Red Sox get a run and tied the score at one.
For every bump that doesn't break you, every turn that doesn't shake you, for every dad that's ever said, "You bet, I'll take you," there's Camry. Could Camry really be that reliable, that safe and dependable? Ask someone you know who drives one.
Get the feeling, get the feeling.
Program in the first, $4.
The summer wind.
Snacks in the fourth. $25.
From across the sea.
A soda at the end of the seventh, $3.
It lingered there.
Friday night, no TV, DVDs, or video games.
And walk with
priceless.
Me.
There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's
all
MasterCard. Devoted fan of Major League Baseball.
I've made a lot of news on the baseball diamonds, but if you want to find out about this diamond, you've got to go talk to your doctor.
Ready to try Viagra for the first time? See your doctor and find out if a free sample's right for you.
My doctor says it's right for me. That's why I stay with it. For more information, go to Viagra.com.
I've been around, you know I can't stay forever.
The Jeep summer sales drive is coming to an end. Get in on it now and get great deals on Jeep vehicles like Grand Cherokee.
When I'm finally gone, I'm gonna be gone without a trace.
Because now, very well-qualified buyers can get a 2004 Jeep Grand Cherokee for $299 a month with $999 down, plus our 770 powertrain limited warranty. So get to your local Jeep dealer before the summer sales drive ends.
You are my number one.
Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back in Chicago. The Red Sox and White Sox tied 1-1, and Carl Everett with a very nice running catch to rob Bill Miller of a hit and to end the inning. Valentin to lead it off this inning.
Carl Everett covering an awful lot of ground out there in center field. Goes into the dive and takes extra bases away from Bill Miller. We noticed down in Texas, Don, earlier in the season, as Burkett has now hit his second batter of the game, Jose Valentin, that to Carl Everett moving much better this season than we have seen in the last couple of years. Apparently healthy this year, which he's had some physical problems over the last couple of seasons, and being healthy, he has much better results.
Well, his knee was really never the same after that injury in Tampa Bay as a member of the Red Sox, and that included his time in Texas in the beginning portions of his career with the Rangers. But this year, the defense is back, and the wheels are working for Carl Everett. Here's Joe Creedy getting the start at third base for the White Sox tonight, batting with Valentin at first, and nobody out in the inning. Burkett starts off ahead. Creedy at 257, 18 homers and 62 runs batted in. And He has 6 home runs in his last 11 games. And over the last 11 games, hitting at .341. As part of this red-hot White Sox batting order lately, this team has really hit very well in the second half, and so has Joe Creedy. Burkett checks on Valentin at first base. Tampa Bay on top of Seattle tonight. 1-0 is there in the 5th inning in Tampa Bay. And that is Joel Piñeiro going tonight for the Mariners against Victor Zambrano for the Tampa Bay Devil Rays. Keeping a close eye on that action, but again, Tampa Bay on top of Seattle, 1-0.
Yankees are off today, right?
Yes, they are.
Yeah, the series up in Toronto. They played yesterday, but they have an off day today.
Roy Halladay beat them yesterday. In the air to center field, shallow. Damon started back, but now comes in. And the sky a little bit easier, but still a tough sky, and there's one down. Boston Red Sox baseball is brought to you by New England Toyota dealers, by Bob Stores, by Coors Light, and by Volvo, the official vehicle of the Red Sox. So one down in the inning, and it brings up Miguel Olivo, the White Sox catcher. 231, 6 homers and 22 runs batted in.
Valentin at first base. He has 5 steals. He's been caught 3 times this season.
Back that time as Burkett checks on him again.
Combination where they could use the hit and run here with Olivo at the plate. He does not walk very much. He's pretty much a free swinger. And a lot of times managers like to put on a hit and run play with those type of guys. They can swing at almost anything and still make contact.
Burkett looking for something to work on the bottom of his cleats, it appears. He into the Red Sox dugout for some assistance. Apparently he's got some mud that is mounted up underneath those cleats, and we'll get him some of those tongue depressors there to go to work on the bottom of those shoes. Mention the fact that this is a very important road trip for the Red Sox. We take a look at where they stand right now in the American League East, 4.5 games back of the Yankees, who did win yesterday, or actually I should say did lose yesterday, 8-1 to the Toronto Blue Jays and Roy Halladay. And then in the wild card scenario, the Mariners with the 1-game lead over the Red Sox again. Seattle playing Tampa Bay tonight and trailing 1-0 at this junction. And the Chicago White Sox have changed some things around since the last time the Red Sox were here. They now enjoy the 2-game lead over the Kansas City Royals and the Minnesota Twins in the AL Central. Burkett has cleared out the bottom of his cleats, now ready to work to Olivo. And he gets a strike in there. Olivo has hit in 5 of the last 8 games, going 7-for-27 at .259. Certainly known more for his defense than his offense. This one back towards the mound. Burkett has it, and he throws out Olivo. Up to second base goes Valentin, with now 2 outs in the inning.
Well, Chicago's pretty excited. I mean, they got the Cubs playing pretty good baseball up on the north side, and you got the White Sox here on the south side leading their division. Crowds have been better here at U.S. Cellular Field. As the host of the All-Star game this year, they've made many improvements to this ballpark over the last year. Seems to be a bit more appealing to come here, not only the ballpark, but also the fact the team's playing pretty good baseball. That is a different area out there. So many years they had trouble with the hitter's background. They have finally made some adjustments out there. It's much, much better. And they get some standing room tickets up just underneath the scoreboard. Have a nice idea.
Very well populated area out there tonight. Beautiful night for baseball tonight in Chicago. Game one of this brief two-game series. The top of the White Sox order. And Roberto Alomar, he doubled his first time up. And came around to score the White Sox only run so far tonight. Alomar, of course, coming over from the Mets, which was a very difficult place to play. This is down the left field line and a foul ball. Fair, but just kept bending away. Look at the active career leaders in the major leagues. Ricky Henderson, of course, back in the major leagues, and on top of that list, Rafael Palmeiro and then Roberto Alomar, 2,665.
And reunited here with his brother Sandy Alomar.
Sox were very active around the trade deadline time as they picked up Alomar. They get Carl Everett. And I think that seemed to give the fans a lot to look forward to here, realizing that the organization was certainly heading in the right direction. Remember a few years ago when the White Sox were in the mix and all of a sudden traded off some pretty key parts, kind of giving the indication that they did not think they were in the mix, and they certainly are here at this stage of the season on top of the AL Central.
Burkett not happy with that last call as we look at Jerry Manuel, the manager here for the White Sox. That's a pitch, that last one Burkett has to have to be effective.
A lot of people surprised that Jerry Manuel made it out of the first part of the season with the way the White Sox started. And now things looking very, very good for the White Sox. Swing and a miss. Alomar strikes out. John Burkett's first strikeout ends the second inning. We play two from Chicago, tied at one.
An anniversary is something you never want to miss, especially this year. The Lincoln Mercury anniversary clearance has been extended. Your last chance for end of the model year savings on every remaining 03 Lincoln and Mercury, including Lincoln Navigator, the new Lincoln Aviator, the new Lincoln LS, and the best Lincoln town car ever, with 0% APR for 60 months or up to $6,500 cash back, plus your dealer's best model year-end price. Hurry to your New England Lincoln Mercury dealer.
There's a better way to stay cool this summer. The same dependable people you rely on for all your heating needs also install, replace, and service Central Home Air Conditioning.
If you like to read in bed, or you like to watch TV in bed, this is the perfect bed. These are regular high-quality Simmons backing mattresses that are modified so they can bend in proper places. The doctor tells you to elevate your feet. Here you can push a button and raise your feet. These beds will fit into any headboard and footboard. They're standard size, and you can even set it so you can wake up in the morning to a massage. Today, they're underpriced. They do make sense. They're a value. Why buy a regular bed when you can have a bed that does so much more?
Your Dodge dealers are counting down the final days of the summer sales drive. It's your chance to get no extra charge lube, oil, and filter changes for up to 7 years. Plus, make zero down payment, zero payments until 2004, and get 0% APR financing or cash allowances of up to $4,500. All with our 7-year, 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. But get rolling, because the final days countdown ends September 2nd. See your Dodge dealer for the best values in America.
That's not an eclipse, right, Jerry?
No, but what's some beautiful property up there. Can we get another shot of that? I'd like to buy a piece of land right here, this spot right here. Look how wide open that is.
You'd like to move there?
Nobody would bother me there, Don.
Jason Varitek leads it off. He waves at that pitch.
Most people want to retire in Florida or Arizona or California. I want to go to the moon.
You want to move to the moon?
There's nobody there. I'm convinced of that.
You bring your chair with you to the moon?
Absolutely.
Veritek grounds it foul over by the Red Sox dugout. 0-2 to Veritek, 5-for-17 against Bartolo Colon in his career. And that includes a home run. Colon has given up just one hit through the first two innings. That was a home run by Nixon. Outside corner, strike three. Jason Veritek with some words for Joe Brinkman as he takes with him the third strikeout of the night for Colon.
Well, the words might be, look, if you're going to give Colon this pitch, then I've got to have the same pitch for John Burkett. Remember last inning, there was one out there that Burkett did not get the call on. Now the same pitch, and Veritek is called out. Please give me the same pitch for Burkett. Joe Brinkman, see him nod his head. Okay, I will.
There's Gabe Kapler getting the start in left field tonight for the Red Sox. Kapler had 292, two homers, and 15 runs batted in. Jolts it into center field. Carl Everett going full bore back and to make the catch. Running onto the warning track to take that one in for out number two.
Well, each time the Red Sox catch a run of stealing on Nesson this season, you get entered to win a LoJack stolen vehicle recovery system for your car or truck at boston.com/Nesson. Simply enter the date, opponent, and run of the Red Sox caught stealing at boston.com/Nesson, and you'll be entered into the LoJack caught stealing sweepstakes.
Two down, here's Johnny Damon. As the Red Sox go second time through here against Bartolo Colon. Damon popped out to the first baseman his first time up. Near the lip of the grass at third is Joe Creedy. This one is popped up foul. Lebo going down the line, and he makes the catch in the fungo circle for the final out. In order to go the Red Sox in the top of the third, we've played two and a half, tied at one.
The Hyundai Elantra, a comparison. More standard features and a more powerful engine than a Honda Civic LX. All for over $2,000 less when comparably equipped. And only the Elantra is protected by America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. Looks like we have a winner. Test drive the Hyundai Elantra. Nicely equipped for just $12,199. At your Hyundai dealer. Hurry into the Hyundai winning season clearance and get up to $2,000 cash back or 0% APR for up to 60 months.
Decision.
Hey, what is it?
I realize I love you, but as long as you're with Jessica, there can never be anything between
Listen,
us.
Cassie, there's no need to cry. Besides, I've got really great news.
You're leaving Jessica?
No. I just saved a load of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico. I saved. I thought that meant something to you.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
For extra convenience, extra value, and extra service, stop at Extra Mart. When you're on the go, you need a little extra. Fuel up on Extra Mart's Deli Joe sandwiches, Brew Boy coffee, and more. For your car, Extra Mart offers the brands you know at competitive prices.
Pick up irresistibly delicious, extra nutritious Nesquik. Now on sale for only 99 cents at Extra Mart. Nesquik, milk made fun.
With over 150 locations throughout New England, be smart. Shop Extra Mart.
Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy along with Tom Caron in Chicago as the White Sox and Red Sox are tied 1-1 into the bottom of the third inning. And Carlos Lee leading it off, the White Sox left fielder. And he flied out to center field his first time up. Burkett missing away that time, and it's 2-1 now to Carlos Lee. Red Sox and White Sox have played four games so far, each team winning two into tonight's action. stretch. The White Sox will be coming to Fenway Park. White Sox coming here twice this season to take on the Chicago White Sox. Down the right field line, bending towards the line, and it'll be a fair ball down into the corner. Nixon digging it out, but not before Carlos Lee stands at second base with a leadoff double.
Pretty good hitting by Carlos Lee. You know, you have a guy out there in John Burkett who's not a hot thrower, tries to change speeds, and Carlos Lee going the opposite field. Look how far outside Jason Buritzek is set, and Lee not trying to pull the ball, just goes the other way, finds fair territory down in the corner. It does stay in play. Oh, did it stay in play? But that ball bounced out of play, didn't it?
Looked like it might have. Tough to tell. We'll see it again, but here is Frank Thomas.
I don't believe the umpire called it a ground rule double.
Against John Burkett, 8 for 19 at 421.
8 home runs in the last 10 games for Frank Thomas.
No swing and a miss there. Fooled on that pitch. Burkett here to take something off.
Yeah, that's the one John Burkett will consistently go to when he's in a bit of trouble, like curveball and change speeds on it.
This time the Red Sox were here, Frank Thomas was playing a little bit more regularly at first base. Tonight being used as a DH. Named by Veritek, not getting the call from Joe Brinkman.
And now Burkett looking in at Joe Brinkman. Now that seems to be the type of pitch that Veritek was called out on. Grady Little at the top step. He may be having something to say to Joe Brinkman. Joe's been around a long time.
A big one for Frank Thomas, who was swinging for the fences there. Joe Brinkman, one of the guys that ejected Jerry Remy at some point during his career?
No, I don't think Joe ever did get me. No. Joe and I had a wonderful relationship. Still do.
Burgess payoff pitch. It's fouled off the right side. On the move is Millar, but they run out of real estate back into the seats.
One thing you might notice with Joe Brinkman, he sets up as far back as you'll see any umpire from the catcher. And this is actually closer. He went through a stretch for a couple of years where he was setting up back in this area here. Now, he's moved up a little bit, but he's still quite a distance from Jason Buritzek. He'll get down on that one knee, but that's quite a ways from home plate.
Lifts it in the air to right center field. Johnny Damon's over. Nixon moving over as well. It'll be Nixon's ball. And he makes the catch holding. At second base is Carlos Lee. And the throw gets away back into the infield. No further advance for Lee. Boston Red Sox baseball on Nesson is brought to you by Lincoln Mercury. By Lojack. By Aflac. By Citizens Bank and by Jeep. So Frank Thomas flying out to right field for the inning's first out. Throws a little wild getting back in, but no advance. Where Carlos Lee stands at second base, and here's Maglio Ordonez. He walked his first time up, the only walk so far given up by John Burkett tonight. Up, foul off third. Bill Miller heading over towards the White Sox dugout, but it's back and out of play.
That's about the area you were sitting yesterday at Wrigley Field to watch the Cubs and the Cardinals play, huh?
It was outstanding once the rain stopped. It was 3 hours worth of rain delay, actually 3 hours plus.
I've never been to Wrigley Field, but you say it's just a beautiful place to go see a game.
Outstanding. First time I've ever been there. And the Cubs and Cardinals met The first game of that series, and it reminds you a lot of Fenway Park. Really does. A lot of similarities there. And certainly the crowd very much into it. Like Red Sox fans are used to at Fenway Park. They had a day-night doubleheader there today. I think the first game may have gone 15 innings to get their day off.
Oh, beautiful.
On a tough start.
Kind of have those cycles, don't you? You have the rain delay yesterday over there for about 4 hours, so that thing gets started late. You go 15 innings in the first game of a day-nighter.
Seem to have those stretches. Well, with the rain delay, at least I got to watch you guys because I could see the game from there, and then your game ended, and then I had a chance to watch the game that I was at.
So. I'd be willing to guess that while you were watching us, you did see a couple of walks.
Yes.
Yeah, because there were
a lot of walks. Some lead changes. It looked like you were there for a good amount of time also, but a good result.
Don, it was a full day, as we like to call it, the business. Burkett and Veritek having a tough time getting on the same page with this 0-2 count to Ordóñez. Tough lineup. This is a very, very good lineup, and it was amazing that these guys were not scoring runs early in the season. They're just too good a hitters on this club. And right now they are hitting.
And they were collectively slumping, as you mentioned, the first time we were here. Very tough to figure out. It wasn't just one or two guys. It was pretty much this power lineup top to bottom that was not hitting. They're hitting now. This one's in the dirt. Veritek can't locate it right away. No advance for Carlos Lee.
Now you give Joe Brinkman a save on that one because that ball got through the legs of Veritek and it hit Joe Brinkman, and that's what kept the runner at second base. See, right there off Joe Brinkman, he starts limping around. Still very light in his feet, Joe, behind home plate. But actually, that did save Lee from going to third base.
We're doing the long pause now, ready with the 1-2. Up left side. Omar Garcia Parra equidistant between second and third. Makes the catch for out number two. Let's check in with Tom Caron. Tom.
Thank you. We've got some Red Sox fans here in Chicago. These are four guys who actually met in Chicago. You're all from different places, but you're all Red Sox fans there.
Brockton, Albany, Duxbury, and North Carolina. We all met our first day of work in 1995. We scattered from there.
Now, Vito, from Albany, New York, you actually were a clubhouse guy and a bat boy for the Albany Yankees, but you were a Red Sox fan.
That's right. In 1988 and 1989, I was clubhouse manager for the AA affiliate of the New York Yankees, which was in Albany, and I had the job for about a year before I was fired by one Buck Showalter.
So Buck Showalter, you had a message you want to say for Jerry Remy.
Buenos no chase, Senor Remy.
Needs a little work, but
Boston accent. That'll kill it.
Guys, back to you.
All right, thanks very much, Tom. He doesn't seem to have the same dialect that you do when you read the...
That was very good. He just got to do it a little faster.
He didn't have the disfrutin and everything else that you mix in. It's an unfortunate story that he was fired by Buck Showalter.
And he has never forgotten that, has he?
No, he's still a little bitter about it, I think.
Made him a Red Sox fan.
Actually did games there at AA. It was in the Eastern League for a long time.
Oh, that doesn't surprise me.
Yeah. Andy Pettit pitched there. Derek Jeter went through Albany.
Did you get a hat or a cap from there?
No. What, to put in front of my desk? Is that where it's going? The 2-0 to Everett is fouled back to the backstop, and it's now 2-1.
Actually, a big play back in the first inning. Everett, with the bases loaded, hit that pop-up. It did drop in, but the Red Sox get an out of it. And that could have been a very big inning for Chicago to start this ball game. Instead, they just got the one run.
In scoring position at second base with two down. Burkett trying to battle his way out of the inning. Passing up top, a little bit inside that time to Everett. It's July 1st, coming over from the Texas Rangers, hitting a 298, seven homers, and 27 runs batted in for Everett. Was part of a pretty good offensive attack down there in Texas prior to coming here to Chicago. Foul back above us. had 18 home runs with the Texas Rangers before coming here to Chicago. Now has a total of 25 on the season. Playoff pitch, golf foul again up off the left side.
Well, that was almost up in the area where Tom Caron is. TC almost got himself a souvenir. What I like about TC is he just stays there and he talks to his guests. It's not like, you know, okay, you're on, and then he blows them off. I mean, he spends some time with him explaining how he would have dove for that.
So you're saying he's not a fraud. He's not the guy just doing there like he cares for the moment, and then afterwards he can care less about them and their story and who they are.
He cares about his guests. Especially for a guy that got fired.
Yeah. Payoff pitch. Everett swings and misses. Briefly gets away from Veritek, so he's got to throw him out. He does so successfully to end the inning. Second strikeout for John Burkett as the White Sox strand a man. We're tied at one. Dixon headed to the corner.
Herman and Sherman Smith lost 100 pounds each with the help of Subway low-fat sandwiches and exercise.
Hey, I'm Sherman, and this is my brother Herman. I was 300 pounds, and I was 290.
Them boys is huge. I used to have to guard my cake around.
For 7 months, we ate nothing but Subway.
Seven tasty sandwiches under 6 grams of fat, like the turkey breast with honey mustard sauce on fresh baked bread.
Before they lost all that weight, I couldn't tell them apart. Now that they done lost the weight, I still can't tell them apart.
Everybody thinks we look better.
They look good now. Not good, but they look good now.
Subway, eat fresh.
Hey, stop everything. Shelterman here, your local Cover It Instant Garage and Greenhouse dealer. You name it, we can cover it. Boats, RVs, four-wheelers, watercraft, cars, snowmobiles, lawn equipment, tractors, work trucks, you name it. Sales, installation, service, the Shelterman covers it all.
Stop in today and call,
because our dad is the Shelterman.
Full-time protection for your part-time toys.
Let me bounce this number off you.
At Quirk Chevrolet, save up to $10,000 on the longest-lasting, most dependable truck on the road, Chevy Silverado. All this and savings up to 10 grand only from the guy who wants you to wear the gold bow tie. Quirk Chevrolet gets you from 0 to 60 in record time with financing as low as 0% for up to 60 months on Maine's number one selling truck. Up to $10,000 in savings, down to 0% financing. Think you can get a better deal than Quirk Chevrolet? Then you don't know, Jack.
Back in Chicago at the end of three, tied at one as we head to the top half of the fourth inning. And the fourth inning is brought to you by KFC's new $4 meals. Real meals, real value. Todd Walker to lead it off for the Red Sox here in the top of the fourth inning. Walker was a strikeout victim in the first, one of three strikeouts tonight for Bartolo Colon. Colon has given up just one hit through the first three innings. That was the home run by Nixon. He was lifted in the air mile high, but not deep, into shallow right for Roberto Alomar. And he makes the catch when it finally comes down for out number one. Well, it's time now for the Aflac trivia question. And our question tonight, who are the only two players to hit seven grand slams for the Red Sox since 1988? The answer for you in the next half inning.
I think I know one of those, Don. But I can't say I know both of them.
One of the answers for you in the next inning. Here's Garcia Parra, who also struck out in the first inning. Colon was able to strike out back-to-back Red Sox hitters in the first. Broken bat grounder to Valentin at short, who throws out Garcia Parra, and there's quickly two down.
We mentioned how Colon is the type of pitcher that can get stronger and stronger as the game goes on. He does have five complete games on the season. Very, very strong, you know. I mean, he's not the poster child for a health club, obviously. He does look like he's trimmed down, though, since the last time that we did see him here in Chicago. But very strong lower body, and that's where he gets a lot of his power from, especially that velocity on the fastball.
Often much is made of his weight. and it seems to fluctuate at times, but it does look like he's a little slimmer.
Well, he's either gotten a little slimmer since the last time, or he's got a bigger uniform,
which can hide it.
Last time we saw him, he really looked heavy.
He's thrown 47 pitches here tonight so far through 3 2/3 innings, and again, he's only given up one hit. As he deals with David Ortiz. Cards one foul back to the backstop, evens the count at 1-1.
And I have noticed that early in this ball game, he's thrown many more fastballs than he did in that last outing against the Red Sox. Almost like he was doing him a favor last time with a lot of breaking pitches.
I wonder why he did that. Maybe just not able to locate that fastball.
I don't know. Maybe he just didn't feel good coming out of the bullpen that day with his fastball and decided to go with a lot of breaking balls that day.
Pitching coach Don Cooper, who we heard from earlier. Fouled off the left side. It's 1-2 now to Ortiz. Last year, Bartolo Colon, a 20-game winner as he won 10 games for the Cleveland Indians. And, of course, wrapping up the season as a member of the Montreal Expos. 10-4 in Cleveland, the identical record in Montreal. 10-4. And of course, a lot of talk about him during the offseason, perhaps the Red Sox trading for him. It was the first time in his career that he was a 20-game winner. Flirted with the 20 games in 99 when he won 18 for the Cleveland Indians that year, going 18-5. And in double figures in wins in five major league seasons. On the ground, left side, a lot of English on it. Creedy cuts it off and gets it there in time to retire Ortiz. 1-2-3 go the Red Sox. In fact, it's 7 in a row. Retired by Colon. We're tied at 1.
Everyday low fares to your favorite vacation destinations start at just $49.
You are now free to move about the country.
Decision.
Welcome back. I'm here in this 19th century Victorian with new owners Mike and Shannon Boyd.
Hi, Ted.
We just fell in love with its charm.
Yeah, it's charming. Unfortunately, the roof leaks, the foundation is crumbling, and there's significant termite damage. But I do have good news. I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico. Hey, we need to talk about your electrical.
Whoa.
Yeah, we're going to want to fix that.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The all-new 265-horsepower Nissan Maxima.
Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back in Chicago. Red Sox and White Sox tied 1-1 as we head to the bottom half of the fourth inning. John Burkett has given up so far two hits here tonight to the White Sox and a run. The run came back in the first inning. Roberto Alomar scoring the White Sox run. Canerco leaded off here in the bottom of the fourth and lined out to right field his first time up. Red Sox have won 7 of their last 8 games at home and 10 of their last 12. This is hit high and deep to left field. Kapler going back, and he will make the catch in front of the wall. Hit a long way to left, and it seemed to die out there, and Kapler making the catch right in front of the wall for out number one.
I think even John Burkett looked a bit surprised that that ball stayed in the ballpark. When this left the bat from Konerko, it looked like it had enough legs to get out of here. It was toward the end of the bat. Kaplan does a nice job spinning around at the last moment to make the catch right in front of the wall. It sounded good, Don, leaving the bat, and it looked like it had enough, but not quite.
That ball just seemed to die out there in left field. There's a very light breeze blowing from left to right. I don't think it was enough to knock it down, but...
light breeze blowing off the lake.
Luis Valentin, who was hit by a pitch his first time up. This is a very light lake breeze.
It's an easterly breeze, Don, that comes off the lake.
Inside that time, and it's now 3-1. Where are we in conjunction to the old Comiskey Park?
Right across the street. As we come in, you know the entrance we come in? If you look to your right, that's the old Comiskey. That's a, it now is a parking lot.
That's where it was, right there? Wow.
Oh, I got no.
Foul back above us, and a full count.
The old Comiskey Park, home plate was facing downtown Chicago. Home plate here is the opposite way. It is facing out toward Indiana.
It was a nice ballpark. It had been there one time, an old ballpark. Did you have much success there? No. I can tell already you didn't like it. Swing and a miss. Valentin strikes out. Third strikeout for John Burkett. Boston Red Sox baseball on NESN is brought to you by KFC and the new everyday $4 meals. Great meals, great prices at KFC. It's an everyday deal. Zell, you were not enamored with the Comiskey Park.
No, actually, I didn't mind it at all. It was, I'll tell you, the fans were great at the old ballpark. But they desperately needed something new. There's no question about that.
Two down, Joe Creedy flied out to center field his first time up. And that slow breaking ball missing inside, 2-0. The Sox outfield set up straight away. The deepest is Nixon in right field. Burkett falling behind here, 3-0. John has walked only one so far tonight. That was Maglio Ordonez back in the first inning.
Let me be careful here because Creedy, the number 8 hitter, has home run power. He may have the green light, 3-0. You got a Levo on deck. Yeah, taking all the way. Like I said, Don, he'll be taking all the way on the 3-0 count. I don't understand that, you know. I mean, you got a number 9 guy coming up that's not a very good hitter. You got a guy that's got 18 home runs. Let him swing away 3-0.
Swings at the 3-1, lifts it to shallow left field. Kapler moving in. And Gabe makes the catch for the final out of the fourth inning. The fourth inning is brought to you by KFC's new $4 meals. Real meals, real value. He played 4, still tied at 1.
Looks like you're enjoying a quality meal at a casual dining restaurant for about $8.
Oh, no. I'm much smarter than that.
So you went to KFC and got the same quality meal for half the price. That's...
genius. I know.
Now get a breast meal, 2-piece meal, or a 3-strip meal, each for only $4 every day. Save even more when you feed the whole family with KFC's 10-piece family meal. At less than $4 a person, you've got to be the smartest family around.
Yeah, we know.
Feed your family for less than $4 a person at KFC.
It was fast. We made it faster. It was smart. We made it smarter. Until it was as close to perfect as it's ever come. And that's saying something. Introducing the new, more powerful ES-330.
The Boston Globe Sports Plus.
It's Sports Plus a whole lot more.
Wednesday night after Red Sox baseball, sponsored by Sam Adams.
It's the Boston Globe Sports Plus on NESN. So what am I doing here?
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's a classroom where the know-how is free and the homework is fun. It's how to build something, or paint something, or plant something. A place that can take you from wondering how to knowing how. And the guaranteed low price every day to make every dollar work. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Introducing Magner's Irish Cider, Ireland's original hard cider, for a unique kind of refreshment. Because let's face it, there's no thirst like an Irish thirst. Magner's Irish Cider, real cider, imported from Ireland.
Back at U.S. Cellular Field in Chicago, tied at one as we head to the top half of the fifth inning. Devin Millar, Trot Nixon, and Bill Miller to face Bartolo Colon, who's still just giving up the one hit. A home run by Nixon, a solo shot in the second inning. Nixon will bat second in the inning. And the home run back in the second inning was his 26th round tripper of the year. Just a grand slam yesterday, a solo home run here tonight. Two and one now to Kevin Millar. Popped out to the second baseman his first time up.
Now you would think, Don, the way the outfield defense is set up, they're going to stay away from Millar. They have Everett shading him slightly toward the opposite field. Big gap out here in left center field for Millar.
For a strike, and it's a full count. All right, the bases loaded, walk in the ninth inning, tied the game at nine, and helped set the stage for Trot Nixon's game-winning grand slam. Two pitches later yesterday. And he takes the walk, close pitch. Red Sox have their first base runner since the second inning. First walk given up by Colon. Let's take a look at the game summary in this one so far. Burkett, four innings, giving up one run on just two hits. Colon, four innings, giving up one run on one hit. He's walked one most recently and has struck out three. Trot Nixon with his 26th home run. Roberto Alomar with a double and a run. And Everett getting an RBI and a fielder's choice. They're tied at one here in the top half of the fifth inning. Here is Trot Nixon, who homered in the second inning towards right center field to give the Red Sox their lone run. Three of the five hits that Trot Nixon has off Bartolo Colon are home runs. Ground to first, nicely speared by Konerko, fires on to second base for the double play. Went around the bag at first, gave him the opportunity to tag that first and then attempt to get Millar, which he did, and there's two down.
And we mentioned this has been a very good defensive team this year, the White Sox, third in the league in defense.